I'm a hustler, baby. I'm a hustler, baby.
I know heartbreaks, setbacks. Bitch, if I crap out, I'm sure I'ma get back. I've been through the ups and downs. You know I've been around. So to me, it's all a part of the game. If I ain't the co-main or the domain, I'm almost for sure, man. I gotta take it. No need to say shit. I'm gonna take it.
Homicide. My favorite part right here. Here we go.
Make money.
When shit hit the fan, we'll take money. Southside. Gunshot at the best of them. Woo! Be with the best of them. Yo, right now I'm with the best of them, all right? It is February 13, 2021, and today was the release of the Jordan 6 Carmine. Has it been released in 2006? Original was the 1999 version. You know what I'm saying? So the last time we saw these was on a countdown pack. And honestly, to say the least, these are boom, figgity fire. I really like these, man. I really like these. Honestly, my boy Hove, he knows, right? Shout out to Hove. He had this pair, the original pair in 1996, and then he had the countdown back, all right? I've always been a hater of the Jordan 6 Carmine, only because I could never have them. And now I have a pair, so that now I can say these joints is fire. So shout out to Hov for all the years that I hated on him. I even had the nerve to say that the Jordan 6 Gatorade is better than the Carmine 6s. To be honest, yes, it was some nerve, and I still stand with that opinion. It is my opinion. I got the right. The Fifth Amendment, son. I'm going to speak it. All right? I could say what I want to say on this channel because it's my channel. You don't like it, log off. You heard? But what I'm going to talk about right now is these Jordan 6s. I feel like, for me, the materials that we use on this are very stiff, all right? It's like a deck of cards when you first put it out the box. You gotta break it in. This is a very stiff sneaker. However, I wanna know what it's gonna feel like when I break it in time, what it would look like. I'm pretty sure that it's gonna hold up very nice. My pair did not come with any pink on it. As you guys know, this release was very in the air because of the fact that a lot of pairs that people received had like a tint of dye right here. It was like pink. It looked pink on the actual air bubble. So there was like a lot of pink going on. A lot of stores did not want to sell that to the customers and, you know, get a lot of returns. Once people buy it, they'll post it. Then after that, they'll try to bring it back and say that it was damaged, so on and so forth. So they just decided that they were going to send their pairs back to Nike. So this was supposed to be a general release, a very wide release, but the quantity on these were limited. They were very limited. So people that were able to hit on certain raffles, like myself, I was able to do a raffle with City Jeans, and I got lucky, and I won the raffle. So if I was you, you got to put in that legwork. You got to put in leg day when it comes to a lot of sneakers and avoid the lines. As you guys can see on Fifth Avenue, on the Nike store, people went crazy throwing haymakers, trying to get in to that first come, first serve Jordan 6 release. And a lot of people were getting, you know, arrested. They were getting kicked out the store because they were just wilding for their pair. So my advice is you put in for these local raffles to your local businesses. Make sure you support them. You know, I know that Nike is the bigger brand, but they have a lot of, you know, people in between that can definitely do right. And you might have a chance to win these raffles. So make sure that you sign up for raffles, you know? And that's exactly what I did. I was able to avoid the line. I was able to avoid the hassle by just doing the legwork, doing my research, putting in for the raffle, and I won, right? So shout out to City Jeans for allowing me to have this. You know, another way that you can win them is doing those Foot Locker things. But honestly, the best place to go is to your local businesses. Ask them how they're doing the releases, if it's first come, first serve, if they're doing online raffles. Follow them on the gram. Follow them on IG. Make sure you go follow City Jeans at City Jeans on IG. You know, that's where they post most of their content. That's where they're going to be able to show you how they're doing most of their releases. So shout out to them. I'm super fortunate to have this. This is a February 13th release, which means that tomorrow was Valentine's Day. So we knew that this release was going to be bananas to begin with. A lot of dudes are going to be asking wifey, hey, yo, ma, can I eat a pair of them Jordan 6 Carmines for Valentine's Day? You know, I'm going to buy you something nice. You get me something nice, too. And people are going to go crazy for these. So, again, I was very fortunate to have them. The materials, you know, I'll give it like about out of 100. I'll give it a 90. It's not the best leather that you can do. You know, the Jordan 6 Gatorade, that leather was stupendous. from the beginning, it was insane. Like, you know, you touch it, it bends. Like, it was just like that real nice, you know, leather. I don't know what to compare it with, but that leather on that Jordan 6 Gatorade was different. I'm not saying that this one is worse, but we got to see what it looks like when you break it in, when you wear it, when you rock it. So I can't wait to put these on my feet. You know, these will go straight on feet. I will be rocking these. You know, I copped a couple of pairs of the Fire Red 4s. I was going to wear those. But now that I got these are going straight on feet more than those. I'm going to save those probably for the summertime or whenever. But I'm not going to throw those on right now. I'm not really like a Jordan 4 head. I like Jordan 6s. They just look better on my feet, and the way they look like with jeans and sweats and, you know, joggers, whatever it is that you rock, it's going to look appropriate, especially with these. And for me, one of my favorite parts about it is this is like oversized Nike Air. Like, I don't know, for me, this right here looks a lot bigger than what it did in the original version. I could be wrong, but it just looks like it stands out more. I don't know why, but it just does. And I just found some glue on this one right here. Look, you know, I'm not going to lie. These pairs had a lot of stuff going wrong with them, but you know, the fact that it's a Carmine 6 on a Valentine's Day, the fact that it hasn't released since 2006, and before that was 1996, to, you know, it's just this sneaker, the history behind it could go on and on. You know, Jordan did play with these on feet, so he had these on the court. He was wilding with them on the court, dunking it on people, shooting fadeaway jump shots, you know, wilding with the up and, like, up and over layups. He was just bugging out with these. So you cannot say that Jordan did not have these on. He definitely did. This was a major release back in the day and is a major release now. Look at that. We're in 2021 and people are still going bananas over something that released in 1996. And it's not even like a high tech sneaker. It's the retro pair of the Jordan brand. And that's how much of an impact, you know, Jordan has on the sneaker culture and even in our lives. Like, you know, we can't really live without Jordan brand. Like, we need a pair of Jordans in our closet, you know, whatever it is. Like, I'm pretty sure all of us has had at least one pair of J's, and we haven't. Then maybe you should try them on and you understand what people are going crazy about. So, you know, shout out to you. Make sure you guys go follow me on IG. It's at Nate_SB. I post a lot of my pictures there, a lot of images of sneakers that you might have never seen or sneakers you have seen, sneakers you probably hate. You know, it's all good. I just need you to go and follow me. We just hit 400 followers on IG. I just started this like a couple months ago. And the fact that it, you know, is going the direction that it is, you know, I'm super appreciative. You know, my videos, I have 59 subscribers, and my videos, some of them, you know, already have like 3,000 views, has a lot of likes, a lot of comments, and I'm just super grateful, which that tells me that the content that I'm putting out is touching people. People are able to relate and they're getting something out of these videos. So I'm just going to keep it pushing. I'm not going to worry about, you know, what people say about me and the way that I do things. I'm just going to move forward and just put the content out there, and it is what it is. So guys, thank you again for following me. Make sure you smash that like button, press that like button, click on the like button, click on the subscribe button, like that. I don't know what it is, whatever you do, how you do it. You know what I'm saying? And I appreciate the support and I appreciate the love. So guys, continue to follow me. Until the next one, this is Nate SB over in...